seeing somebody, even when you're no longer close to that person. I mean, there's such a thing as treating somebody with civility and respect. And so we ask the men at the beginning, at the end, we ask them whether they've really kind of whether we've affected their level of respect for their the mother of their children, during the course of attending this 12-week program. And reassuringly, a lot of the men, most of the men, I think it was like 3/4 of them, say that their level of respect for their mother has increased.
Really?
During the time. And the
number. Think they're just telling you that because that's what you want to hear?
Well, I think it could be some of that, but I also think that one of the things we do is I think that a lot of fathers, when they start having to be have dedicated time with their children, like post-divorce or post-separation, for some of them, it gives them a new appreciation for what is involved in parenting, and some of them will say things like, I never realized what hard work it was, being a parent. I used to think my ex, she was lazy. She'd just be at home all day, with the kids, I didn't really think she was doing anything. But spending a day with a 3-year-old, oh my God, that's a lot of work. I mean, because they constantly want your attention, And you really can't like slack off, I mean, they're very insistent on your attention. And so in the parenting program, we're very kind of specific about what a 3-year-olds need, basically,
Really?
Right. What kinds of things make sense for a 3-year-old? For instance, 3-year-olds are naturally curious, and so they get into things, If you're kind of a part-time parent, then you're more likely to sort of want to punish your kids for getting into things as opposed to child-proofing your house. And better monitoring, them, and kind of appreciating the fact that that's developmentally very healthy for kids at 3 to be curious about things, and so that just requires just more monitoring, and more kind of like more kind of like sidetracking them and getting involved with them, getting them on the floor and playing with them and that sort of thing, so that. I mean, there's a lot of involved, and interestingly, a lot of the men, once they're in that position, they will then sort of like really appreciate the role that the mother played, and say, well, God, I mean, I realized that she was really doing a lot,
So you learn from these remarks that they make to you, not just by them telling you, oh, I've learned a lot, but from the specific remarks, you can see that they're really learning something and gaining something out of the program.
Well, and one of the questions we ask at the end is, what is something that you've learned from the mother of your children about being a parent? And so they write, things that they've learned. And they write some very specific things, some very, very good examples of things that, that they've learned. If you want to really be an effective parent, you have to sort of get down, to their level, and really understand them and talk to them, and not ignore them, for instance. So that would be an example of what one man said, for instance. So that we're really trying to get them to sort of not just, kind of realize what kids need, but also kind of realize what's involved, in being a parent, and being an active parent, mm-hmm. being an engaged parent.
So can anybody enroll in the parenting classes?
Well, I mean, what we say is that the program is specifically geared for men who have had some type of either abusive or controlling behavior towards the other parent.
Okay.
So it is specifically geared for that.
Do they need to be referred by someone, or is it,
No, a lot of men coming into the group have been, well, some of them are referred to the courts, some of them are referred by DCF, some of them are many of them are self-referred, some of them just decide, maybe they're divorced, separated. Some of them actually still living with the mother of the children, but they've just been basically asked by the mother, to get more information about being a parent, being mm-hmm. a better parent.
So anyone can call Emerge and contact you and see if they might be suitable for the parenting class and then sign up.
Yeah, and they're free of charge, so that and we offer them 3 times a year,
Okay.
12 sessions.
12 sessions. And are they scheduled in during the day and the
Wednesday
evening?
Wednesday nights, 8 to 10.
Okay.
Yeah, so that it's a time that, you know, is you know, available for most people.
Well, great. That's a great resource to Cambridge residents, so that's great to know about. David, thanks a lot for meeting with us today. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome.
There's brunettes, blonde girls, blue jeans, string of pearls. Take you on a trip around the world, girls. Love has a thousand faces. Love has a thousand faces. There's debutantes, drama queens, glued to Bride magazine. Half calf to pump, no whip in the coffee bean. Love has a thousand faces. Love has a thousand faces, but I see you. Before I ever knew you, before I ever knew you, I dreamed of you. A small town, itty bitty tomboy in a big city. Turn your head when the light ain't red. Stop traffic, kinda pretty. Love has a thousand faces. Love has a thousand faces, but I see. Thunder crashing, mystery full of passion, quiet as a Sunday morning, change without any warning. Love has a thousand faces. Love has a thousand faces, but I see you. And I see you. I see
his brunettes, blonde girls, blue jeans, string of pearls, take you on a trip.
Baby, I see. Traffic kinda pretty.